Man. That was exhausting.
That was a rush, man.
You guys showed up.
Yeah. I tore apart that
house.
Thought
he wasn't supposed to be there.
Yeah. Something got mixed up, man. That was a mess.
Hey, you okay? What's the deal? Well, that's gonna leave a mark. Look. It'll be okay. You're gonna be okay. We got enough stuff. The boss is gonna be happy.
Need some more, right?
Hey, man, you don't go telling Mama about that little Nick.
Hey, come on. He's a kid. Come on. Hey, look at it this way. You're gonna have plenty more rough and tumbles in your life. And this ain't the first one that you've been in. I know it. And this ain't gonna be the last one, all right? Come on. Hang in there, all right? But one thing I've been wanting to talk to you about, okay? You might want to think about taking that other job you were telling me about. Hanging out with these clowns over here ain't going to be, no offense, but it ain't going to be the best thing for you, okay? And one more thing. Someday, happiness is going to find you right when you need it. Okay? Never forget that. Where are we off to next?
Intelligent, but not brilliant. Pampered from birth as the only child of aristocrats. And crippled by polio. Franklin Delano Roosevelt was hardly predestined for a rendezvous with presidential greatness. But his political...
Dad?
Yeah, Chris?
How come you and Mom work so much?
Working is what allows us to stay together. And because at the end of the day, that's all we really have.
Come on, let's just eat our dinner.
Let my dough.
Here's the pitch. You've seen their stories. They've all done something big in their lives, but they've also worked extremely hard for what they currently have. For your final exam, I want to hear about your story. Now, you may not have accomplished as much as, let's say, FDR, but you've accomplished something in your lifetime, and that's the story I want to hear. I want to hear about the real you. Hello. Mm-hmm. I'll send him right down. Charlie?
Charles Calloway?
Charles Calloway, can I call you Chuck?
No, thank you.
Mr. Calloway is then. Do you have any idea why you're here today?
Is it my grades, sir?
No, I don't even know where to begin, Charlie. I've never had to do this before. It's your parents. There's been a horrible accident. On the way to work today, your parents, they passed away, Charlie. I'm sorry, and as sure as you can understand, we can't disclose all the information. But we're gonna let you go home. Take your brother. We haven't told him. And I'd figure coming from you would be much better than from us. I'm sorry, but you know, we really can't, you know, talk much more about this today.
I'm not going home.
What?
I have to stay in school.
Mr. Kelly, you know, each person deals with grief differently.
I can't go. Tell Chris, do whatever you want.
And I'm obliged to tell your situation in 2 weeks. I have to report it in 2 weeks.
I'm staying at school.
There's a lot of services we can provide for you, that we can talk to, homes you can go to.
Hi, Doc. It's Charlie. Whatever you do, don't get me that desk job. I'll talk to you later. Are you going to lunch right now? Right. Well, I am too, so we can sit together, yeah?
Okay.
Okay. Do you sit out here every day? 'Cause my friends and I sit over there, and I've never really seen you out here before, and it's weird that I've never noticed you. Watching people, do you ever just watch people? Sometimes it's just like...
Look, I know what you're trying to do, and I don't need you to ask me all these questions, and...
I'm not trying to do anything besides make conversation. I'm Lucy.
Charlie.
I know, you're in a lot of my classes. Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. Why does it matter?
Why wouldn't it matter? Have you ever skipped school?
No.
What if we did right now?
What the hell? Why would I do that right now?
Well, why not?
Because it's stupid.
How's it stupid?
Because it's...
It's not stupid.
They'll notice me if I'm gone.
They'll notice me too.
No, you don't get it. They'll really notice me.
What makes you think that they'll notice you any more than they'll notice me?
Well, Because...
Take it easy. We would have to. You're telling me you don't want to? You don't want to have fun? For once? Come on. Please?
Okay. So, how did you find this place? I mean, I didn't even know places like this existed.
It was my sister's favorite park.
What do you mean, was?
Do you want to go on the swings again?
No, what do you mean it was?
Because she's dead. Her name was Allison. She died when I was really young. She used to take me here all the time. We would go on the swings and see who could go the highest without flipping over the bars. Since we're sharing stories, how'd you get those bruises?
From working.
Sounds rough.
You have no idea. Gracie, wake up.
When are Mom and Dad gonna be home?
They won't be coming home, Gracie.
Where are they?
They're gone. It's just the three of us now. They're gone. They're not coming back. Mom and Dad got in a car accident. They're dead, and they're not coming home. And now all we have is each other. It's just you and me and Chris.
Adrian?
Here.
Sierra?
Here.
Alyssa?
Here.
David?
Here.
Ian?
Here.
Chuck? Chuck Calloway? Hassan?
Here.
Yeah, Lucy?
Can I use the restroom?
Yeah. Kevin?
Here.
Kara?
Here.
Vicky?
Here. Hi, Charlie, it's me. You weren't here again, and I'm getting kind of worried. If you could just give me a call and let me know that you're all right, that'd be great. Okay, bye.
Money and Gracie's money.
Oh, that money. Well, you know, it costs money being a teenager, but you wouldn't know that, would you?
What do you mean?
Tonight, I'm going out, and I'm partying. I can't sit around here and be sad like you, because, you know, I have a life, even if Mom and Dad don't. I'm not crazy. I don't think you're some kind of great superhero.
We need this money, Chris. It's not just about me or you. It's all of us. It's for Gracie, all we have.
Yeah. All we have is each other. You know what? You can have everybody in the damn world, and that still wouldn't be enough. Blood money, that's all it is. Oh, and a little brotherly advice? Next time, try to get a girlfriend, try not to pick up damaged goods. She's just as messed up as you are, and everybody knows it. Thanks for nothing.
Good for something. You have a key. Open it yourself.
It's me.
I came to see if you're all right. You haven't been in school in a week.
I'm fine. Thanks for asking.
You don't think I can tell when you're lying? What's going on with you? How come you haven't been talking to me?
What do you want me to do, Lucy? Fall into your arms and cry?
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about me. I'm talking about us. Why are you so obsessed with
my life? Because I care.
You don't care.
What?
Yeah, I'm on to you. Opening up to me. You don't care. You don't care whether I'm happy or not. I'm just your new Allison. That's all.
How could you even...
Don't make this about you. You're not the victim here. I am. Remember when you asked me about those cuts and bruises? Well, let me tell you something. They're about this job I have, this night job. I start at 10 at night and I don't stop until 5 in the morning. I break into houses and I steal everything. And we repossess houses that the bank forecloses on because that's what we're paid to do. And I use my minimum wage check to make sure that my house doesn't end up next on the list. I don't talk to people because why should I? You let people in, and they manipulate you, and they spoil your secrets, and then they leave you alone to take care of a brother and sister and a million other problems. There's more to gamble than the game is worth, Lucy. Is that what you wanted to hear? Do you still think you can fix me?
Bye, Chuck. Something. What was that?
Good evening, guys.
Just continue.
Good evening.
It was a long strip.
Thanks for meeting with me. We want to discuss Charles Calloway.
Hey, Anderson.
Okay. Is this going to take long?
It shouldn't take too long. I know it's late, so we'll make sure that we can get through it as quickly as possible. Here's his file, if you guys don't mind looking at it for a minute for me.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So what are we gonna do about this kid?
I don't see what the issue is. I think we should just call social services. They'll be here in a few days, and it's done. It is standard procedure.
I think it's more complicated than that.
Anderson, why is there more to it?
Mr. Calloway is a 17-year-old senior. He's looking to graduate. He does have a younger sibling in high school and another one in elementary school. What makes it so complicated is recently both his parents passed away in a car accident.
But he's a good kid, decent grades.
Considering the situation and what he's going through, he's a good kid and he's pretty stable. But looking at his grades here, To be honest, Principal Miller, they could be better.
What do you mean by could be better?
I mean, they're subpar to say the least. And I recently had a conversation with this language arts teacher. He said if he doesn't have a C on the final exam, he's not going to be able to graduate.
His grades are not the only issue here. If we don't report him to social services and they find out, then we can lose our job. And we're already risking too much.
Well, when does he turn 18?
Looking through his file, he does have a birthday coming up in a couple weeks right before graduation.
Anderson, what do you think?
Now, considering the situation that his parents recently passed away, I think this kid needs more time.
Tell you what, with the amount of days that this kid's been missing, he's got to be working somewhere. Anderson, I want you to dig around, find out what you can find, and then we'll deal with that. There's no way I'm going to lose my job over one kid.
I'll look into it. I'll make some phone calls and see what we can dig up, what information we find. Thank you guys for your time.
Okay, it's a deal then. We'll call CPS and get him out there within the next couple days, and it's a done deal.
All right, thank you. Appreciate it.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you.
So dinner. What are we going to do?
You guys have a good evening.
Bye, Machine.
Charlie, hey, it's Doc. Hey, I want to let you know I got let go today, buddy. I can't help you out any more than I have. I think I might have bought you some time. Maybe a week, maybe more, I don't know. But I don't think it's a good idea if we see each other. At least not for now. Okay? And not for a while. I wish I could explain, but it was risky enough calling. But listen, you got your repo job. You hear? You got it. And hey, say hi to Gracie for me, okay? I'll see you later.
Hello, Charlie. It's Mr. Anderson. I'm just calling to give you a heads up that your case, well, the Calloway family, that is, will be forwarded to Child Protective Services in the next couple days. We don't usually make phone calls like this, but I thought it was necessary considering the situation. I would have filed it early, but I had a lot of trouble regarding the job at the repossession office.
Grace?
Have a good night, Charlie, and talk to you soon.
Gracie!
I know you guys aren't here right now, and I thought maybe we could meet here. I just wanted to say goodbye, and I'm sorry. I'm sorry I'm not getting good grades, and I'm sorry Chris is gone, and I'm sorry I can't take care of Gracie. And we might not be able to stay together, and I know family's all you have, but it's just really difficult right now, and everything's so messed up, and I'm trying. It's just...
Whatever you want, don't you?
I do, don't I? Now, could you get out of the way? I'm trying to watch my TV show.
No, listen to me. I'm your older brother, and since Mom and Dad aren't here now, I'm in charge. Listen to me, get up. Sit up. Just because they're gone doesn't mean you can do whatever you want. I need you, Chris. Gracie needs you. We all need each other. Where is Gracie?
She's in her room.
What's wrong, Chris?
CPS called today.
What did they say?
They said they're looking into us, Charlie. It's not gonna be much longer.
It'll be okay.
You don't know that though.
I don't know. Just don't worry about it. I mean, what good is worrying gonna do? Is Gracie okay?
I haven't told her yet.
Go play with Gracie.
Yeah, so my parents have been gone all weekend. I've just been really bored. That flower you got me really was pretty.
It's no problem.
How did you know that was my favorite color?
Lucky guess, but Lucy...
Really lucky,
but... Lucy. Look. I don't want to drag this on, so I'll make it brief.
Ever since that night you left my house, I haven't been able to stop thinking about the things I said to you.
And I just want you to know how sorry I am. And you know what else? A few weeks ago, my parents died. In a car accident. And I became so wrapped up in myself that I wallowed in my sadness and I didn't think of a way to solve my problems, and that's not how things get done. And now Gracie, Chris, and I, we need your help.
Gracie's been falling behind in school, and Chris took the family money, and my final essay's due tomorrow, and if I don't pass it, I don't graduate. And I don't know what to do, and I'm terrified, and I'm sorry.
You know what, though, Charlie? I need to apologize, too. I've never told anyone about Allison before, and, well, you do remind me of her, and well, that makes me want to help you, but that's not why I like you, and I'm sorry if you felt that way. You really are a great guy, Charlie. Let's go to your house and write that essay.
Okay, so as you know, the final exam essays are due today. After you've turned yours in, you may silent read for the hour. At this point, you may bring them to the front of the room.
Hello, Charlie. How are you today?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm doing well. Thanks for asking.
Have you done something different about the room? It looks different from the last time I was in here.
Yeah, we got some new furniture, tried to lighten it up, make it a little bit more welcoming. What do you think?
It's noticeable.
Good.
Well, why did you call me?
I called you down here to congratulate you in person.
Congratulate?
Yeah, I just spoke to your language arts teacher. He's already read your paper.
And?
Well, got to say, you knocked it out of the ballpark. And he gave me a copy too. You did an excellent job. You're quite the writer.
Well, thank you.
You know, on a more serious note though, Charlie, everyone here at the school is very proud of you. What you've been able to accomplish is truly, truly amazing. Everything you've overcome, the death of your parents, graduating, we're very, very proud. And I'm not just saying that because I have to. I really mean it. So good job. I got something for you. So wait.
What is it?
Take a look. Congratulations.
I don't know what to say. Thank you.
You're welcome. And if you need another size, I can get you a different one. All right, so just let me know.
Thanks. This is the best news I've had in a really long time.
Oh, you deserve it, Charlie. But listen, I don't want you to get too excited too fast. I also have some bad news. You know, due to some complications with talking to your work, and more importantly, an unruly employee who lost your file, it's taking quite a bit of time to get your file out to CPS, a lot longer than usual. And here's the deal. You graduate in a couple weeks, right? And you turn 18 soon, right?
Yeah.
Well, to be honest, I don't think I'm going to be able to get that file out to CPS before you turn 18. And here's the good part. Once you become a legal adult and you turn 18, all the rules change. So I don't think CPS will be able to take any drastic measures against you, like splitting up your family. And most likely, it appears, they're going to be able to get you with a suitable family member real soon.
Thanks, Mr. Anderson.
I'm just doing my job. You know, I'm really proud of you. Congratulations, Charlie.
That means a lot.
No. We're proud of you. Good job. Congrats. Now get out of here. You know, I don't want to see you around here anymore.
All right.
Take care.
You too. Hey.
Well?
Well?
What's behind your back?
Nothing. Just my cap and gown.
Oh my gosh. How?
I'm graduating.
Oh my gosh.
The teacher said I knocked my essay out of the ballpark.
Well, I have another surprise for you. Do you want to come over for a little bit?
Okay.
I'm Lucy's Uncle John. Her dad, Mike's my little brother. Have a seat.
Okay.
Lucy tells me that you're not doing too well, and we thought we could give you a hand if you're willing to do some work.
They own a construction company, and, well, they needed a few more hands to help, so I figured I would give them you and Chris's names.
Really?
Absolutely. You'd be making a lot more than you do now, and it won't be under the table either.
Yeah, I'll do it. But I've got one more name I think you should consider.
You know, I'm really glad Lucy got us this job. This house is really nice.
Hey, it's Lucy. Come on, let's go.
Glad we get to go home.
Yeah, but I mean, at least
you're
getting paid better.
It's a good job. It's good pay.
I won't have to steal from Gracie's money jar anymore.
Hi.
Hey.
Hey, Lucy.
Just go tell the boss we're leaving.
Okay.
Yo, boss!
He really enjoys working.
I can tell.
He'll catch up with us later.
Oh, okay. So, how's working with my uncle?
Absolutely amazing. I really can't tell you how much this means to Chris and I.
Don't mention it. It's no problem. You guys really do deserve a cool job. So, what did you get on your final essay?
A B plus. Teacher said I really opened up.
I'll say.
Maybe I've been sleeping in class a bit too much.
Probably.
You've been doing that a lot lately.
At least you're showing up now.
You haven't touched your chicken, Chris. What's wrong? Nah. Too tough? Can't cut it? Way too tough for me. I don't know about you. What happened? I thought you were the man. I thought you were invincible.
I made something for you.
What is it? You know, this is the prettiest flower I've ever seen.
Thank you.
Do you mind if I take it with me to put it in my pocket?
No, not at all.
It's a picture of our family, and I want you to have it.
So, Charlie, how's your new job?
Good, thanks for asking. Safe.
Yeah, thanks.